This video is going to show you the progression that I went through in order to figure out a way to camouflage my wheelchair. The first picture there shows the first time I went out after my accident, and the best example of that is it shows how totally desperate I was to get back outside. The camouflage got caught in my wheels, and it was a real horror show. In 2002, I was able to buy a 4x4 wheelchair, which greatly aided in my efforts to hunt again. Now I could back into the hedgerow and camouflage, but it still took a second person to place the camouflage over me. And one thing I wanted to do was to be able to hunt by myself. This is an outhouse blind. It has no bottom in it, and you can back a wheelchair in and open the windows and hunt from whatever side you want. I found it claustrophobic and did not like it, and it requires you to go to the same place all the time. The first real break I got came when someone suggested to me using snow fence and covering it with camouflage. On the right, you can see the first blind a friend of mine helped put up, and this is where I shot my first turkey from this particular blind. But it was 11 years in developing all the things I needed to do. I discovered fake ivy, which is little more expensive than regular camouflage, but it makes a great blind cover. On the right, you can see a blind. I usually have them put up in the early spring so they have a time to blend into the vegetation before the hunting season starts. This is a blind I hunt from quite a bit. The fellow across the road lets me put up these blinds and just leave them there, and I have a number of different places in his fields where I can go in order to hunt. The one thing that I like so much about the snow fence blind is I can go there by myself. These are some commercial blinds that are now available and I use once in a while. The one below is called a mirror blind, and it is absolutely marvelous. It was a Christmas gift given to me by my son, but it's actually fairly expensive. Without a doubt, the hardest part of getting back into turkey hunting from a wheelchair was having to be stationary and bring the turkeys to you. This is the land across the road from my house where my blinds are set up, and you can see I've marked dusting spots and game trails when they move and that, and I've been very fortunate. It took 11 years to harvest my first turkey, which is upper left picture. But since then, I've been pretty consistent and had quite a bit of positive luck. For information on turkey hunting and a lot of other topics, you can go to my website, handyhelp.net, and everything that you need is right there.